All right, here is another physics question that I am going to attempt to answer while talking about what I am doing in order to answer it. The question involves forces and friction. The question is, determine the force F, shown here, necessary for impending motion up the plane. So that means the force F that's required to start the block moving up the plane, not to keep it going, since they might be different things. The coefficient of static friction here is 0.2, so that means I'm going to write down mu s for coefficient of static friction equals 0.2, and that's going to be important information later. Now, the first thing I'm going to write is the definition for the force of static friction. So I'll call that Fs is equal to mu s, which is a number we know, times the normal force. That's just a definition. Force of friction equals the coefficient of friction times the normal force. And I can draw these forces on the diagram as well. The force of static friction goes opposite the direction of motion, so it has to go this way in the direction of the plane. And the normal force always goes in a direction perpendicular to the surface that you're on. So I'll draw it acting on the block here. That's the normal force. And if you draw kind of a dotted line, you can show that it has a right angle that it makes with the plane. Then the other force that's acting here is the force of gravity, which always goes straight down towards the center of the Earth. So FG, force of gravity. Now, since we know that this block is 150 kilograms, I can figure out the force of gravity, or the weight, right away. FG is going to be equal to the mass times the gravitational acceleration, which is 150 kilograms multiplied by 9.8 meters per second squared, which is just what we assume the gravity to be, since that's what it is usually approximated as on the surface of the Earth. So I'll figure that one out. 150 times 9.8 equals 1470. And that'll be in newtons. So I know one of the forces already. I just decided to figure that out as soon as I could see it there. Now, the question is asking what this force is. So we need to start drawing free body diagrams to figure that out. So I'll draw a quick free body diagram. So here is the block. We have the force F going in this direction. There's the static friction going kind of down in this direction, the same direction as the plane, so it has the 12 and 5. It's kind of drawn in badly there, but it has the right numbers. The other forces are FG and the normal force. Since the normal force is perpendicular to this force, it'll have the opposite slope or triangle here. That means it has 12 going up and 5 across. Now, I need to come up with a couple of equations here. There are two main equations that I'm going to use to solve this problem, the two of the equilibrium equations. So the sum of the forces in the horizontal direction have to be equal to zero, and also the sum of the forces in the vertical direction have to be equal to zero. I think I need to start by looking at the vertical to solve this problem, because that's usually how it works with friction problems. You find the force of friction using the normal force. So let's look at all the forces here that move either up or down. So in the free body diagram, you've got the normal force, the force of gravity, and the force of friction here. Those are the three forces that move in an up or down type way. So they all have to be in there, but some of them are going to be components. So first let's put in the force of gravity, since that's the easiest. It just goes straight down, so negative Fg. Then the normal force goes up, and it's the 12 that is the up component. So let me draw this triangle somewhere. This is the 5, 12, and 13 triangle. So for both of these slopes, the hypotenuse is 13. So using ratios instead of trigonometry to figure this out, let's see, plus n times the component going up, which was 12, divided by the hypotenuse, which represents the vector itself, 13. Then the force of gravity, wait, that's not the force of gravity, the force of static friction, only 5 out of the 13 is going down. But it is going down, so I need to make it negative. So Fs times 5 over 13. So, the good thing about this is that I can replace the Fs with the definition. The coefficient of friction times n. And I can also replace Fg with the value we found for that 1470, which makes it solvable because there will only be one missing unknown left, which is n. So I put negative 1470 plus 12 over 13 times n minus 0.2. That was the coefficient of static friction here. So I'll just write down force of static friction here is 0.2n. That was from the question. So 0.2n times the 5 over 13. So now I'll leave the n terms on one side and the non-n terms on the other. So we have 12 over 13n minus 0.2 times 5 over 13n equals 1470. Now, by factoring, we have n times 12 over 13 minus 0.2 times 5 over 13 equals 1470. Now I just have to figure out what this number is. Actually, forget that. I'll just write it out. N equals 1470 over 12 over 13 minus 0.2 times 5 over 13. It's over all of that. And I can do all this in my calculator. Divided by bracket 12 divided by 13 minus 0.2 times 5 divided by 13 close bracket equals 1737. Oh yeah, just round it off to 1737 newtons. So back up to what that actually means. So found one of the forces in the free body diagram going up this way. Now I still need to find F, the pushing force that's making it go this way. And for that, I need the horizontal version of that equation. So let's look at all the forces going horizontally. We still have N, only this time it's the 5 over 13. And it's negative because it's going to the left. There's also the force of static friction, so that's force of static friction times 12 over 13 and F. So plus big F equals zero. I'll just make a little line here to separate. Now I know that F equals, by moving the other things to the other side, 5 over 13n plus 12 over 13, and instead of Fs, I'm going to write times mu n, and everything on the right side is known. 5 over 13. The value of n was 17. It's hard to see now, there's so much stuff here. 1737. Plus 12 over 13 times 0.2 times 1737. So, see if I can do all this in one. This is 5 divided by 13 times 1737 plus 12 divided by 13 times 0.2 times another 1737 equals 988.75. I'll just round it up to 989. That's the value for F. Therefore, the force needed. What was the wording of the question? It was asking the force necessary for impending motion. So I'll write that down. The force needed for impending motion, in other words, to overcome friction and cause motion to happen, is F equals 989 newtons. And that's the end of the question. Hope you enjoyed that.